Hi and welcome to IT Chronicles 10 in Tech. I'm Kirstie Magowan. We're coming to you from Knowledge 17. My co-host today is Carlos Casanova.
Hi, Kirstie.
And we're pleased to be here with David Abramowski from ServiceNow.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Now, David, big announcement around the cloud management stuff today.
So, yeah, absolutely.
So can you tell us a bit about what that's all about?
Yeah, so we've announced a new edition of our cloud management application. Mm-hmm. On the ServiceNow platform.
Yep.
And what this does is it allows us, allows organizations to deliver cloud services or cloud resources to their end users in kind of a mm-hmm. consumer-like fashion.
Right.
But IT gets to stay in control. That's right. Really the key. Mm-hmm.
So you're looking at trying to stop so much of the shadow IT going on where, you know, people are just going out and saying, oh, just grab this from here and grab that from there. So
exactly
it's giving
right.
IT that overview now.
Yes, absolutely.
A bit more control.
Yeah, so when you think about what's going on inside of businesses today is that with the, you know, the adoption of DevOps,
yes,
and you know, developers just need more and more resources to mm-hmm. get their job done,
yep,
is that the manual processes that usually happen today create these big bottlenecks.
Yes.
And so what we're trying to do is we're making it so that it's as easy as a service catalog that you're used to with ServiceNow,
mm-hmm. yep,
and you can order those cloud resources that you need, and they automatically get provisioned.
Right.
So when we see some of our customers, they're talking about differences of weeks to months to stand up environments mm-hmm. down to 5 minutes.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, the automation provisioning side of things, you know, even if you're not a DevOps shop, right, that's key because in any of us that have been around for a while, the lead time on that. And
right.
worse is you go into those environments and, or those situations, you don't really know.
Right.
You're guessing, I yep. need five of whatever it is, right?
Yeah, exactly.
And it turns out that you need eight. Or you got five and, you know, we only needed one.
Yep.
So now mm-hmm. you've, you know, so there's a cost associated there, which I would assume that's a huge factor for a lot of the ServiceNow clients. And you know, the expenditure and the upfront type thing.
Absolutely. So when you look at like the way, I mean, you have so many different developers that have to stand up services or use services,
yeah,
and you don't want to have to, like you said, guess in advance to what you need. By us giving self-service to those users, they can stand up what they need when they need it,
right,
they can shut things mm-hmm. down, and we also provide some additional, like, really unique capabilities. Because we're on the platform and we understand kind of about the users, who they are, we can assign things like budgets to them.
Right.
We can assign quotas. We can make sure that they don't launch things that are outside of their quota allotment.
Right.
If it does, it goes into workflow, right?
Okay.
So it goes
yep.
for approvals.
Right. So, I mean, and I haven't played with the I had played with the development platform, and you know, so it almost sounds like that, but now to the commercial side. So you mm-hmm. could go to the ServiceNow development side, spin up an instance, you're good. It times out after a while. You have certain things. So it sounds like you've almost kind of packaged that into a commercial aspect to the base product for the cloud provisioning.
Yeah, I mean, you know, it's a whole separate animal. You know,
yeah,
when you get into dealing with all of the different cloud providers,
right,
AWS, Microsoft Azure. You've got lots more coming
sure.
out of the playing field, or they call it the cloud wars.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, we've taken that whole idea of how do you quickly spin something up, how do you manage it, how do you shut it down and control it, and we've built that into a product.
Right. Cool. That's really cool. I mean, that's,
yeah,
I see, you know, huge opportunities with that. Just from an enablement perspective, you know, and again, as more companies, especially go to the more agile models and the DevOps models, that's got to give them, you know, huge flexibilities
yeah.
to grow with.
Absolutely, and it gives them full control. So one of the other features that we added mm-hmm. is also the ability to take in all the bills from the different cloud providers
right.
and have a
yep.
single picture. So
okay.
you know what typically happens is even if you're mm-hmm. using just Azure or you're just using AWS, you still have dozens of accounts.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So how do you get that one picture of what mm-hmm. you're spending? And so
right.
we pull that into our platform, we pull that into our application and give that to the IT team.
Okay, so that's interesting. So it's not, you know, and I guess maybe some of the folks that aren't that familiar with it, it's not really just the front end. The front end's probably the easy part,
yep.
right? Catalog kind of thing. So it's really the back end that sounds mm-hmm. like that you've done the real hardcore background integrations with all the providers. You're doing the aggregation of those, you know, 7,500 accounts that opened up on Azure or AWS. So that, I mean, I, from a leadership perspective, I would mm-hmm. see that's really the win that
yeah.
they love. The developers love it because they can spin something up,
yeah.
shut it down.
Yep.
But from a leadership perspective, I mean, that's where I would be really, you know,
yeah.
Excited about.
Gives you a much better picture of the
yeah.
reality of your whole situation rather than
that's correct.
Guess. Before a lot of guesswork went into, I think, Yeah, I think this is what we've
got. I hope.
I hope this is what the bill's going to be at the end of the month.
Yeah, and so we take that guesswork out by basically front-ending this whole process with ServiceNow. You get like this visibility you didn't have before.
Right.
And so you have visibility into what you're spending. You have visibility into what they're allowed to provision. Yeah. You have visibility to make sure that it's compliant.
Right.
Right. That you're enforcing the right standards all the time. And that's truly important to the leadership.
Right, right. Yeah, I'm kind of thinking forward already now, like what that will enable.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you change, like you said, if you change standards, if you change new compliance regulations, if you say, hey, we're spreading out into another part of the world that has different compliance requirements, you can say, okay, you're not permitted to spin up an instance.
Absolutely right.
In for the US, you're doing, you know, for New Zealand.
Yep.
And hey, guess what? You can't do that in New Zealand. Yep. So the instance that you're going to get is already baked in, compliant with New Zealand or UK or whatever.
Absolutely. So you just uncovered one of the beautiful parts about ServiceNow, which is we actually, as a user of ServiceNow, we know that information about you.
Right.
And you don't even have to make choices where you can make mistakes. We can automatically enforce these policies with what we know about
you. So you only get to see what you are actually
to do. Correct.
I would think, but yeah, the flexibility, I guess, the key is, right? So if it is someone that works across multiple regions, say you're only authorized to work within these two regions.
Yep.
Which one do you want?
Yep.
Which one? I'm building across both of them. Okay, fine. Here's the converged model of what it is.
That's correct. Yep.
Wow, that's pretty wild. That is pretty cool. So, you know, obviously, there's a lot more to it. What else have we not touched on that's kind of baked in there?
There's this whole kind of like idea of how we're bringing this together in what we call a multi-cloud fashion.
Yes.
So there's one thing to be able to deploy services out to AWS or out to Azure, right? But you could use their platforms to do
that.
Where we become really, really interesting is when you want to think about those cloud service providers like a utility.
Mm-hmm.
You think about them like electricity, right?
Yeah.
Where do I want to run it? Now we know underneath the covers, you have to know different commands and different ways and different nomenclature for all of those platforms.
Right.
But what we've built is this blueprinting system that allows us to kind of abstract all of that into a layer.
So you're more or less translating from the front end to the back without you actually having to know what happens in the middle.
Exactly. And so what happens in the middle, we've actually even made that easier for the cloud architect because we use these things called resource blocks that are basically, think of just like a bunch of Legos.
Yes.
And we assemble those Legos together, irregardless of the cloud it's going to run on.
Yep.
And at the last minute, we can say, okay, that's going to run on AWS. Okay, that's going to run on Azure. And there's all different reasons why you would put them in different places.
Well, and I was just going to ask you about that. So, I guess I'll just ask the question. I mean, you kind of partly answered. Is there logic in place that says, this is the type of thing I'm going to do, or this type of thing I normally do? This better performs on AWS versus Azure or whatever it is, even from a costing. You know that you have certain contractual situations with one versus the other. We need to move more that way or this way. Mm-hmm. So I would think that from a corporate perspective, you could actually do all that on the back end without me knowing, her knowing, anyone like that. And you could actually redirect it as leadership demands.
Mm-hmm. That's exactly correct.
Yep.
So when you think about what we have in this first version, this version that we're releasing, the next version, I always say first, but it's really the next.
First
first new one for me.
First next version.
The first next version, yes. Basically, we have the infrastructure in place to make those decisions at the last moment, at deployment time. And we may not have like all the features in there that allow us to do things like really like robotic yet.
Right, right.
But eventually that's all going to get there, right? Because we're building the infrastructure or that structure to get us there.
That is wild. I mean, that's definitely, obviously we've been talking to a lot of folks here, from ServiceNow, a lot of vendors. From my perspective, that's probably one of the more interesting ones because we're always looking at the enablement, the automation of some of the simple things. So thanks so much for coming on board and telling us about this. I look forward and wish you the best with this. I think, great opportunities coming forward with this.
Great. Well, thanks for having me. I really appreciate
it
today. Thank you.
Great to meet you, David.